Good afternoon, everybody.
مساء الخير للجميع.
It's good to be with you again.
إنه جميل أن أكون معكم مرة ثانية.
And I have the pleasure of having with me today and with you today, Pastor Barry Silverback.
ومن دواعي سروري يكون يانا القسيس سيلفرباك.
Our church is a part of CRC Churches International.
كنيستنا هي جزء من CRC Churches International.
Pastor Barry is our International Missions Director.
القس باري هو مدير الكنائس CRC International.
Pastor Barry was a missionary in Papua New Guinea and the Pacific Islands for 40 years.
في بلد اسمه Papua New Guinea كان هو missionary بذاك المكان 40 سنة.
And has planted and overseen churches in many nations in the world.
وزرع كذا كنيسة حول العالم.
We consider Pastor Barry to be an apostle of our denomination.
احنا نعتبر القس باري رسول لكنيستنا.
So it's a great privilege and pleasure to have him here today.
فهو من دواعي سرور أن يكون معنا حاضر هذا اليوم.
That he could bring the word of God to this new congregation.
حتى ما يجلب كلمة الله لهذه الكنيسة.
So I ask you to welcome him as he comes to preach the word of God this morning.
Good afternoon.
مساء الخير.
Very nice to be here with you.
أحب أن أكون معكم هذا اليوم.
You don't need to look at me, you can look at them. My daughter is married to an Egyptian.
بنتي هي متزوجة مصري.
So he speaks Arabic also.
ويتكلم اللغة العربية أيضا.
And of course his mother and father, they are from the northern part of Egypt.
وأهلهم من مصر أيضا.
So I'm happy to be here.
أنا فرحان أكون بوسطكم.
So are you happy?
أنتم فرحانين؟
You must show it on the face, okay?
لازم تروع على وجوهكم.
Now I'm married with five children.
أنا متزوج عندي خمس أطفال.
One wife.
زوجة واحدة.
19 grandchildren.
19 حفيد.
And three great grandchildren.
وثلاثة أحفاد أولاد أحفادي.
And my wife Rosalie is praying for this service today.
وزوجتي روزالي هي تصلي من أجل الخدمة اليوم.
She is in Adelaide.
هي بأدلايد.
Have you heard of Adelaide?
سامعين بأدلايد.
Better place than Melbourne, I don't know.
أحسن من ملبورن. ما وافق.
I'm really delighted to be here, and I've thanked Pastor for inviting me.
أنا أشكر القسيس من أجل دعوتي لهذه الكنيسة.
So don't feel sorry for me today. Feel sorry for him.
لا تشعروا بأسف إلي اليوم أشعروا بالأسف من أجله.
I will try and slow down my English for him.
It should be okay.
It should be okay.
Should be right.
Okay then. You said it's okay. I'll just see. Well, I'm delighted. I travel to many countries, and this is my first time to be in a gathering like this.
سافرت لمدن كثيرة وهذه أول مرة لي أكون باجتماع مثل هذا.
In Papua New Guinea, we have 950 different languages, not dialects, languages.
ببابغيني عندنا 950 لغة.
And we border Indonesia.
Sorry.
We share a border with Indonesia.
احنا على الحدود ويا الاندونيسيا.
And they have 350 languages there.
هم عندهم 350 لغة.
So I am used to being in a place where I have to use an interpreter.
فأنا متعود أن أكون مكان أن يكون مترجم لي.
He's an interpreter, but usually an interrupter.
هو مترجم لي بس عادة هو ما يكون يقاطعني.
So it's a pleasure to be here with you, and I'm going to share some things about Jesus today.
أنا راح أشارك معكم بعض الأشياء عن يسوع في هذا اليوم.
In 1958.
1958.
How many of you were born before 1958?
كم واحد كمال
1958 I became a Christian.
ب1958 صرت مسيحي.
I was a drunkard.
You were
a drunkard, you know.
أنا كنت دائما أسكر.
I didn't know about God.
ما كنت أعرف عن الله.
And I lived a very unusual life.
وعشت حياة غير طبيعية.
But the Lord Jesus Christ came into my life.
لكن دخل يسوع المسيح إلى حياتي.
In the 17th of December, November 1958.
19 November 1958.
And I was delivered from many, many things very instantaneously, immediately.
وتغيرت أشياء كثيرة عني رأسا.
And so my life was turned upside down.
وحياتي تغيرت رأسا على عقب.
And my employer that I worked with,
والمدير مالتي كنت أشتغل وياه,
he thought I had a mental breakdown.
أعتقد إنه كان عندي حالة نفسية.
And he called my parents to drive some 150 miles.
واتصل بأهلي حتى يجون للمدينة اللي كنت عايش فيها كانت بعيدة.
Said you need to come and get your son and put him in a psychiatric hospital.
وسالهم إن يأخذون ابنهم يحطه بمستشفى الأمراض.
Because really, I was changed immediately in 2 hours of an encounter with Jesus Christ.
لأن أنا تغيرت بطريقة غير طبيعية بعد ما دخل الله إلى حياتي.
In 1959, I started to preach.
في 1995 بلشت أبشر.
And I've been trying to preach since then.
ومن ذاك الوقت أنا بلشت أوعظ.
Praise the Lord. So I'm happy that Jesus saved me.
أنا فرحان إنه الله أنقذني.
Are you happy too?
I'm very happy.
No, I mean that Jesus saved you.
Oh yeah, of course.
How many of you know that Jesus has forgiven you of all your sin?
كم واحد من عندكم يعرف إن الله خلصه؟
Wonderful. You know that is the most important thing in life.
تعرف إن هذا هو أهم شيء بحياتك.
To know that the burden of guilt of our sin has been lifted from our lives.
إن تعرف إن حمل الخطية اللي على حياتك هو انشال من عندك.
When He forgave me of my sin.
لمن سامحني أو غفر لي خطاياي.
And my sin was big.
وكان خطيتي كبيرة.
But of course the Bible doesn't say there are big sins and little sins.
بس أكيد إن الكتاب المقدس ما يقول إن أكو خطايا كبيرة وخطايا صغيرة.
It's just sin.
هي بس خطية.
But when He forgave me.
لكن لمن غفر لي.
He removed those sins from me.
انشالت هاي الخطايا من عندي.
As far as the east is from the west.
مثل من الشرق عن الغرب.
Never to be remembered again.
راحت بعد نسى الموضوع.
And the joy of forgiveness.
وفرحة المسامحة والغفران.
Is still with me today.
هو بعد وياي لحد اليوم.
Wonderful, wonderful.
رائع وعظيم.
Thing that Jesus did.
إنه الله عمله بحياتي.
And I want you never to forget that.
ومرتكم أبدا تنسون هذا الشيء.
The most important thing that could ever happen in your life.
إنه أهم شيء حصل بحياتك.
Is to have the burden of guilt removed from your life.
من ينشال الثقل الخطيئة من حياتك.
Through the grace and forgiveness of our Lord Jesus Christ.
من خلال النعمة والغفران من الله.
I'm going to talk to you from one verse found in the book of Isaiah.
راح أتكلم ياكم من إشعياء.
And Isaiah chapter 42.
إصحاح 42.
And we're going to read verse 43.
راح نقرأ من إصحاح 42. Verse 43. So was it verse 43? Yeah.
Isaiah
42,
verse 3. Now, in this verse, it is speaking prophetically. It's speaking about Jesus, but he was not yet born. Maybe 700 years before he was born, Isaiah the prophet speaks about Jesus.
700 سنة قبل مولد المسيح حكى إشعياء عنه.
And he speaks about two very clear things in this verse.
وهو يتكلم عن شيئين واضحين جدا في هذا العدد.
He says the gentleness of God
لطف الله
and the justice of God
وعدالة الله
meet together in this man Jesus Christ.
يلتقوا مع بعض في هذا الرجل يسوع المسيح.
Gentleness.
اللطف.
Can you get them to say it in your language? Gentleness.
ممكن تقول الكلمة لطف.
All of you.
اللطف.
Huh?
اللطف.
Come on.
اللطف.
You can't go to sleep on me. You have to participate.
بعد. قولها بعد صوت أعلى.
Yeah. Now you got it, huh? Yeah. Let's all say it together.
خلنا نقول مع بعض. اللطف.
How? There is the justice of God. Let's say justice.
خلينا نقول عدالة.
العدالة.
العدالة.
Don't look at me. Look at them. They're more happier than me. All right, the gentleness and the justice of God.
لطف وعدالة الله.
They meet together.
يلتقون مع بعض.
In the person of Jesus Christ.
بيسوع المسيح.
Now I don't have a reed here.
أنا ما عندي قصب بهذا المكان.
But you have them in many places of the world.
لكن موجود القصب في كذا مكان في العالم.
Have you described what a reed is?
تعرفون شنو القصب؟ قصب البردي.
You know sometimes when wind or somebody walks through the reeds, they not only bend but sometimes get slightly broken. Now it speaks about the gentleness of Jesus that he would not break a reed, a bruised reed, one that was damaged.
لما نحكي عن لطف الله هو ممكن انه لطف الله او gentleness انه تكسر او تحرك ممكن القصب او من كسر.
In other words, a reed that has been badly damaged and is what we would call in English bruised. Let me explain.
Yeah.
When you badly hit your skin
لما ينضرب جلدك
and it bruises, there's a mark comes up.
أو مثل علامة احمرار.
Okay, a reed can be bruised by some object or wind or stone or something that has moved against it and caused some damage to it.
فالقصب بأي حركة خفيفة أو أي رياح أو أحد يمشي مني ممكن تنكسر بسهولة.
But it says that a bruised reed he will not break. He won't snap it.
لكن تقول إنه إذا حتى تكون مكسورة شوية أو متأذية القصب فالله ما راح يكسرها.
He will not break it.
ما راح يكسرها.
He will not destroy it.
ما راح يحطمها.
He is kind and gentle towards it.
هو كلش يعتني بها.
Now we're not going to light this, but this is a very poor candle. But anyway.
الشمعة ما راح نفتحها.
But you know that when a candle burns down at the wax.
تعرفون لما الشمعة تبلش تحترق وينزل الشمع.
And there's no more wick left.
وبعد ما يبقى فتيلة.
And it starts to flicker.
وتبلش تنطفي.
At the last signs of a candle burning out or dying.
العلامات الأخيرة إنه الشمعة راح تنطفي وراح خلصت يعني.
And it says about God's gentleness.
ومنتحكي عن عنايات الله ولطف الله.
That He will not snuff out a smoking candle. He won't destroy the flame.
هو من تكون شمعة مفتوحة ما راح يطفيها.
Because the candle is near the end of its life.
لأنه الشمعة متوصلها مرحلة هي نهاية حياة الشمعة.
It has no more wax or wick.
ما موجود لا شمع ولا فتيل.
To burn.
حتى تحترق.
So he says a smoking flax or a smoking candle.
فهو يقول إذا تكون الفتيلة مدخنة.
He won't put it out.
ما راح يطفيها.
He won't kill the flame.
ما راح يقتل الشعلة.
Now these are pictures of the gentleness of God.
هذه صور من عناية الله ولطف الله لنا.
But they are also a picture of His justice.
لكن سأريد لكم صورة من العدالة.
A lot of people talk about God as being love.
كثيرين يقولون الله محبة.
The love of God.
محبة الله.
And that's a wonderful thing.
وهذا شيء رائع.
But He's also a just God. He is a just.
Oh, هو الله العدل.
You see, many times in the dealings that we have in life.
مرات كثيرة بحياتنا الأشياء اللي نمر بها.
I'm talking about the things that happen to us in life.
عند أحد الأشياء اللي صارت لنا بحياتنا.
Some of them are not fair.
بعض منهم مو عدل.
They're not just.
مو عدل.
They happen to us when we did not deserve them.
صارت لنا من إحنا ما استحقينا الشيء.
And of course, I work in many countries where bribery is very big.
وأنا راح البلدان كثيرة وهي الرشوة هي شيء كبير بذاك البلدان.
Where families, children steal from their parents.
أطفال يسرقون من أهلهم.
I don't mean steal money.
ماذا أقصد يسرقون الفلوس؟
But they steal property.
لكن يسرقون.
They steal inheritance.
Worth.
You know, inheritance,
yeah.
Property. Worth. You know, whatever it might be. And so we have many people who give us a bad deal.
عندنا كثير الناس يعطونا مثل يعاملونا بطريقة سيئة.
And in the commercial world.
بعالم تجاري.
Some people make promise when they're selling you something.
كثير ناس يوعدوك بشيء لما يبيعوا لك الشيء
I was a salesman for a lot of my life.
أنا كنت أبيع أشياء كثيرة.
And I used to sell things.
وكنت أبيع.
For a living.
حتى أعيش.
While I'm preaching the gospel.
بنفس الوقت اللي كنت أوعظ.
And I noticed a lot of salesmen tell lies.
ولاحظت إن الكثير من الأشخاص اللي يبيعون. يكذبون كثير.
They tell you the refrigerator is a very good one.
يقول لك إن هذه الثلاجة هي جيدة جدا.
And 2 months later it breaks down.
وبعد شهرين تخرب.
Made in China.
مصنوعة في الصين.
You know we get a bad deal. We don't get a fair deal. We don't get justice.
مرة كثيرة نتعامل بطريقة سيئة. ما يكون شيء عادل أو شيء نستحقه إحنا.
But God's not like that.
بس الله مو هيك.
He's a just God.
هو الله عدل.
He actually gives us a good deal, a fair deal.
يعاملنا بطريقة جيدة.
He doesn't rob us.
ما يسرقنا.
He doesn't steal from us.
لا يسرق منا.
He doesn't damage us.
ما يحطمنا.
He doesn't do bad things to us.
لا يسيء لنا.
And the things that He's promised.
والأشياء اللي وعدنا
إياها he keeps
ينفذها
his integrity his honesty he's telling the truth
هو دائما يقول هو دائما
You see, God can be trusted.
الله ممكن نثق به.
Some people we cannot trust.
بعض الناس ما نقدر نثق بهم.
Because we don't know what kind of a attitude or deal we'll get from them.
لما نعرف شنو الطريقة اللي راح يعاملونا بها.
But you see, in this verse, it tells us about God's gentleness towards those who are bruised and to those whose life and hope and faith is almost gone out.
لكن في هذا العدد يتكلم عن لطف الله لنا لكل الناس الذين مروا بتجربة سيئة.
I started drinking when I was 15 and a half years of age.
بلشت أشرب الكحول من كان عمري 15.
And as I progressed, I could see that the alcohol was imprisoning. I became a prisoner to drink.
صرت مثل سجين لهذا المشروب الكحول.
And I wondered how I could get out of it.
كنت مقيد ما كنت أعرف شلون أطلع من هذا الوضع.
Now I was not religious.
ما كنت متدين.
I never went to church.
ما رحت الكنيسة.
I didn't even know if there was a God or not.
ما كنت أعرف إذا كان أكو وجود الله أو لا.
Now I was born here in Australia.
أنا ولدت في أستراليا.
And you might think Australia is a Christian country.
وأنت يمكن تعتقد أن أستراليا هي بلد مسيحي.
But not everybody who lives in Australia is a Christian.
بس مو الجميع مو كل واحد يسكن في أستراليا.
And I didn't know if there was a God or not.
ما كنت أعرف إذا كان وجود الله.
I was not brought up in a church or religiously. I had good parents. But they were not religious. And so I did not know where to turn to become free from the alcohol. And at the age of 21, I was very, very much imprisoned by drink.
وفي عمر الواحد شهرين دخلت السجن بسبب الكحول.
And there were moments in my life where I felt great despair. I felt like I couldn't go on.
كان هناك أوقات في حياتي بحيث ما حسيت إنه أقدر أكمل بعد.
And it was like my life was like the candle; it was going out.
حياتي كانت مثل الشمعة على وشك أن تنتهي.
I was like the reed that had been so badly bruised and damaged. Because it's not just drink, it's all the friends that you have and the association and the environment of which you live in. It's a lifestyle.
كانت مثل القصب اللي على وشك على ينكسر بس هو مو بس هذا الكحول ما يسبب بس هذا الشيء بس هو الأصدقاء كنت معاهم كانوا أيضا سيئين لي ولا حياتي.
So they're stealing and lying and running from the police and all kinds of things. And you see, my life was badly bruised by sin. Because without Jesus, I was like Adam.
كنت مثل آدم.
In the Bible.
في الكتاب المقدس.
He was without God.
كان بدون الله.
He was in sin, bound by sin.
كان في الخطية.
And I was like that.
وكنت كنت مثل.
Now of course the world is like that.
وأكيد هذا الشيء العالم.
The Bible says that all have sinned.
الجميع الكتاب المقدس يقول الجميع أخطأوا.
Everybody.
الجميع.
There is not one good person in the world.
لا يوجد شخص ما يخطئ بهذا العالم.
According to God's word.
حسب ما يقوله الله.
We're all sinners.
احنا خطأ.
Sin has bruised our lives in different ways.
الخطية أثرت على حياتنا بطرق كثيرة.
It's left its mark upon our lives.
عفت مثل مثل علامات بحياتنا.
You see, when we damage our skin, there's a mark, a blood mark, a bruise, a blue.
لمن أذي أتصادني يكون مثل علامة حمراء وعلامة بنفسجية.
Now not all of us can see that sin has bruised us.
ومو كلنا نشوف إنه هي الخطايا مؤثرة.
I only learned about that after I became a Christian.
أنا تعلمت هذا الشيء بس لمن صرت مسيحي.
Sin was good for me.
الخطية كانت جيدة لي.
I didn't know sin was wrong.
ما كنت أعرف أن الخطية شيء غلط.
Some things I knew, but some things I didn't.
بعض الأشياء عرفت بس بعض الأشياء ما عرفت.
Because everybody else is doing it, so it must be right.
يعني كل أصدقائي كل الناس عارفهم كانوا يسويها فكان كان عبالي إن الشيء صحيح.
So my life was badly bruised by sin.
فكانت حياتي متأثرة بسبب الخطية.
And it was like the broken reed.
كانت مثل القصب المكسور.
The bruised reed.
القصب المكسور.
And my life was like a candle that's almost the life and the energy has gone out of it.
وكانت حياتي مثل الشمعة اللي على وشك أن تنطفي.
And then I learned.
بعدين تعلمت.
The night that I came to Christ.
بعد ما قبلت يسوع مخلص على حياتي.
Of His gentleness.
تعلمت لطفه في حياتي.
He could have killed me.
هو كان يقدر يقتلني.
He could have snuffed my life out.
هو كان يقدر أن يطفي حياتي.
He could have judged me.
كان يقدر أن يحكم علي.
He could have destroyed me.
كان يقدر أن يحطمني.
But it says a bruised reed he will not break.
لكن الكتاب المقدس يقول إنه القصب المكسور هو ما راح يكسره بالكامل.
And a smoking candle he will not snuff out.
والشمعة اللي على وشك أن تنطفي ما راح يطفيها.
See, that's the kindness and mercy and gentleness of God.
هذا هو عناية الله علينا بحياتنا.
And I hope that each of you have experienced the gentleness of Jesus Christ.
وأنا أتمنى كل واحد منكم اختبر عناية الله على حياته.
The gentleness of God as expressed in Jesus Christ.
عناية ولطف الله اللي روانيها يسوع المسيح.
And what does it say about his justice?
وماذا تقول عن العدالة؟
Well, it tells us how God is just to make sure that you get a good deal.
كتاب المقدس يقول إن الله عدل وراح يتأكد راح يكون نتأكد إنه راح نمر بتجارب جيدة.
In the book of Psalms.
بمزمور.
Chapter 18,
18, verse 35.
He is speaking here about salvation.
هو يتكلم عن الخلاص.
You can read it.
Yes.
Psalm 18, verse 35.
مزمور 18, العدد 35. يقول وتجعل لي ترس خلاصك ويمينك تعضدني ولطفك يعظمني.
It says your gentleness has made me great.
تقول لطفك يعظمني.
Now greatness according to God's word.
Sorry, say that again.
Greatness according to God's word, according to the Bible.
ماذا يقول الله عن العظم؟
Is different to how the world calls greatness.
هو مختلف عن ما يقوله الناس عن عظمية الله.
Quite different altogether.
مختلف.
Because you could be great in the world and in the eyes of many people.
ممكن أن تكون عظيم بعيون الكثيرين.
But you're not great in the eyes of God because you're still a bruised reed and a smoking flax.
لكن يمكن لا تكون عظيم في عيون الله لأن يمكن تكون على مثل شمعة على وشك أن تنطفي أو مثل قصب على وشك أن ينكسر.
But the book of Psalms says your gentleness.
ولكن يقول بالمزمور ولطفك.
Has made me great.
يعظمني.
Now there is another translation of this verse.
هناك ترجمة أخرى لهذا العدد.
And it says like this.
وتقول.
Your stooping has made me great. Now, stooping, you know.
انحناء.
I have to. I stooped.
انحنأت.
Down. Think of this.
فكر بهذا الشيء.
Jesus stooped down.
المسيح نزل.
He came down from heaven. The book of Philippians, chapter 2. He made himself a servant and took upon himself the form of a man. And he came down. He stooped down. His kindness. His gentleness. His goodness. You a good boy?
I can say I am.
You should know what the word goodness means. You see, Jesus, through his stooping down, through dying upon the cross, through his redemptive work of dying for the sins of the world, has made me great. I'm somebody. And you are somebody. You're not nobody.
Okay.
He gave to you dignity. He gave to you identity. He gave you worth and value. What's that? Okay. You see, the greatness that you have as a believer and a follower of Jesus Christ is the result of Jesus dying upon the cross for you and for me. And his dying on the cross was the expression of his stooping down, his gentleness toward us. Our lives were bruised by sin. By Satan. And all of his evil hosts. Our lives were bruised because of sin. And we had no hope of life within. We're like a candle that is almost going out. It's at its last flickering stage. But he stooped down. He didn't break the reed. He didn't snuff the candle out. But his gentleness was such that he saved us. He made us something. Hey, you know that? You're somebody? Huh? Now, some of you have come here to this country under different circumstances. And maybe you have been looked down upon. People may have considered you of little value. Oh, but I am somebody.
Come on.
I am somebody. You're somebody. David, you're somebody. Mark, you're somebody.
And Mark.
Yeah, because of his gentleness.
Not
where I was born. Not because of my education. Now, some of you don't have a name like Silverback. We are very famous. They named the gorillas after us.
You never
heard of the silverback gorillas?
ما سمعتم بالغوريلا اسمه silverback?
But you see, it's not my name. It's not my name that gives me value.
هو ليس اسمي اللي يعطيني قيمة.
It's not where I was born.
ليس مكان ولادتي.
It's not my educational status.
ليس شهادتي.
It's not the kind of work that I do.
مو شغلي.
You know, I mean, he gave some fancy name to me. He gave me a fancy name that they call me an apostle, you know, but
سماني رسول.
It's not because of that.
بس لكن ليس بسبب هذا.
It's the gentleness of Jesus.
عناية ولطف الله.
He stooped down and he said, "Silverback, I'm going to lift you up.
لينخفض من السماء وقال السيلفرباك أنا راح أرفعك.
I'm going to make you into something.
أنا راح أجعل منك شيئا.
If any man be in Christ. If any person be in Jesus, he's a brand new person.
شخص جديد.
The old has passed.
الشخص القديم راح.
And the new has come.
وأنت بلشت.
I'm somebody.
أنا شخص معين.
I've got dignity.
عندي كرامة.
And value.
وقيمة.
And worth.
أنا أقيم.
And so do you.
وأنت أيضا.
Because it doesn't come from your background or your circumstances, it comes from the stooping down of Jesus.
لأن القيمة ما تجي من خلفيتك أو من أنت تجي لكن من انخفاض أو من نزول المسيح على الأرض من السماء.
The New Testament calls that the good news.
العهد الجديد يسميها الأخبار الجيدة.
So don't look so serious. You can be happy about that.
فلا تكون جاد. Huh?
God won't be angry if you smile.
الله ما راح يكون غاضب إذا ابتسمت.
But what about the justice?
ولكن ماذا عن العدالة?
I like this because if you read the first four verses of Isaiah 42, you would see that he is championing the cause for justice in all the earth.
إذا قرأت أول أربع أعداد من إصحاح 43 من إشعياء راح تشوف إنه ما الله عدالة في العالم.
Jesus is committed to the cause of establishing justice for every man and every woman and every child.
الله حاب أن يكون عدالة لكل رجل ولكل أمرأة ولكل طفل.
Not human justice.
مو عدالة إنسانية.
But the justice of God.
ولكن عدالة الله.
And so it's very clear here.
فهذا شيء واضح.
That whatever God has promised you.
كل ما وعد الله بك.
He makes sure that you get it.
هو يؤكد
من حصوله. That you receive it. Now think about when Jesus died. We call the part of the Bible the New Testament.
جزء من الكتاب المقدس نسميه العهد الجديد.
We have the Old Testament.
عندنا العهد القديم.
And we have the New Testament.
عندنا العهد الجديد.
But the New Testament, another word is the New Covenant.
العهد الجديد هو مثل ال.
It's a contract.
العقد الجديد.
Okay. Now the New Contract is His will and testament.
العقد الجديد هو وصيته لنا.
Now, when my father died,
لمن مات أبوي,
he wrote a will.
كتب وصية.
Well, he didn't write it after he died. He wrote it before he died.
هو ما كتبه بعد موته, بس كتبه قبل موته.
Okay, now, when he wrote that will,
لما كتب الوصية,
that is has no power. That will has no power.
وصية ما بي أي سلطة.
Until my father dies.
لحد وفاة أبي.
Now it has power.
الآن هي صالحة.
So we have a person we appointed.
فبوصية أكو شخص معين.
Maybe a lawyer or we call an executor. That's a
محامي أو الشخص المنفذ.
Okay, he calls all the family in.
هذا المحامي أو المنفذ يجمع العائلة.
And he opens the will.
ويفتح الوصية.
And he reads out what daddy left me.
ويقرأ ماذا ما تركه الأب.
Well, he didn't leave me anything actually because he didn't have anything.
هو ما ترك لي أي شيء لأن ما كان عنده أي شيء.
Except he left me his good character and his good things that he put into my life, but I'm trying to explain about Jesus' will and testament.
لكن ترك لي شخصيته الجيدة والتي أثرت على حياتي، لكن أنا أتكلم عن خصية الله في حياتنا.
And the man reads out what is written in the will. The executor reads out all of the details of what my father wrote in the will.
كما المنفذ يقرأ كل ما موجود في وصية.
He said all of our house.
يقول كل من في البيت.
Will go to my mother, to his wife.
راح يصير تابع لأمي.
Okay, so then that becomes law.
وهذا يصير قانون.
Now, of course, there are some people who pay bribes.
لكن بالطبع أكو ناس يدفعون رشوة.
And they tell the executor, don't read all in the will, only read a little bit.
ويقول المحامي أو المنفذ إنه ما يقرأ كل وصية لكن بعض الأجزاء فقط.
And he doesn't say everything that's in the will.
وما يقول كل ما في موجود في الوصية.
Because they have made some secret deal, they'll get some benefit from.
لأنه أكو شيء سري إنه ممكن أن يستفاد منه بعدين.
But this is not true about Jesus.
لكن هذا شيء غير صحيح عن المسيح.
He wrote a will.
كتب وصية.
And he said you can have grace and mercy and forgiveness.
وقال أنت ممكن تملك النعمة والغفران.
He said you can have eternal life and joy.
يكون عندك حياة أبدية استمتع.
He said you can have power and authority.
ويكون عندك سلطة.
He said many, many things written in his will as your inheritance and mine.
ومكتوب بوصية الله إن راح نرث الكثير.
He said, "You who were a long way off from God are now brought near to God."
يقول أنت اللي كنت بعيد عن الله أنت ستكون قريب من الله.
You have peace with God.
عندك سلام مع الله.
You have joy.
عندك
you have forgiveness.
غفران.
You have access for forgiveness if you say sorry.
عندك مثل طريق لي يكون مثل وصل بين الله وانت على المسامحة.
He says you have a father.
يقول لديك أب.
And you have a brother.
أخ.
Father, God.
أب.
Jesus, your brother. And the Holy Spirit, your friend, your comforter.
والروح القدس صديقك.
Oh, there are many things written in the will.
هناك من الكثير مكتوب في الوصية.
So when Jesus died.
لما مات يسوع المسيح.
Now the will has power.
راح تكون الوصية أكو تأثير.
But he did not give this to some other man to read out to everybody what was in his will.
بس هو ما أنطى وصية إلى محامي أو نفذ حتى يقرأ هذه الوصية.
On the third day he rose again.
لكن باليوم الثالث هو قام مرة. قام.
And the Bible says he is the executor of his own will.
والكتاب المقدس يقول إنه هو كان منفذ وصيته.
And if you read his will and testament.
وإذا تقرأ وصيته.
You'll read all of your inheritance.
راح تقرأ كل الأشياء اللي راح تورثها أنت.
And he won't hold anything back.
وما راح يبقى أي شيء خارج
الوصية. He won't hide anything.
ما راح يخفي أي شيء.
He won't keep anything from you.
ما راح يخفي أي شيء عنك.
He'll give you a fair deal.
هو راح يكون عادل معك.
He will be just.
هو راح يكون عادل.
And the justifier.
والعادل.
Of all of us. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive us all our sin and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness and to cleanse us from all our wrongdoing. You see, that's the justice of God.
هذه هي عدالة الله.
He's making sure that every one of you and me know what's written in his will.
هو يريد يأكد إنه كل شخص موجود في هالمكان يعرف ما مكتوب في أوصية.
And it's yours.
وهي لك.
Freely. You don't have to pay for it.
ما تحتاج تدفع.
You don't have to work for it.
ما يحتاج تشتغل.
You don't have to pray for it.
ما يحتاج تصلي.
You don't have to fast for it.
ما يحتاج تصوم.
He already gave it to you.
هو أعطاك الوصية.
So What a wonderful story this is.
كم قصة رائعة.
Gentleness.
لطفه.
And justice of God.
وعدالته.
You can always get a good deal with Jesus.
دائما الله يكون عادل معك.
And I've been on this road for 50 whatever it is. 50
وأنا بهذا الطريق من 50 سنة.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Let's pray.
خلونا نصلي.
Father, we thank you.
الله نحن نشكرك.
That this message would be real.
إن هذه الرسالة تكون حقيقية.
In the hearts of everyone who has heard today.
لقلوب الجميع الذين حضروا اليوم.
May their Christianity.
مسيحية.
Be more than just a historical fact.
صلي أن تكون مسيحية تكون أكثر مما شيء تاريخي فقط.
Or intellectual understanding.
أو شيء تعليمي.
Let it be an emotional thing for them.
خلي يكون شيء مؤثر على شعورنا.
Let it affect not only the head but the heart.
خلي يتأثر على قلوبنا ولكن وليس فقط على عقولنا.
The beauty of Jesus.
جمال الله.
In his gentleness.
في لطفه.
Towards our lives.
على حياتنا.
And his justice.
وعدالته.
To plead our cause.
نكون عادل معنا في حياتنا.
To stand up for us.
ويدافع علينا.
To defend us.
يدافع علينا.
Before Satan.
قبل أن
يهاجم. Who seeks to accuse us.
الذي يريد أن يأثر في حياتنا.
Jesus is a just man.
المسيح هو رجل عادل.
And he is the justifier.
هو العادل.
He makes us right before God.
يريدنا أن نكون جيدين أمام الله.
Through his justice.
من خلال عدالته.
Thank you for all that you have done for us, Jesus.
شكرا من كل شيء عملته من أجلنا.
Thank you for your compassion.
شكرك من أجل عطفك علينا.
Your kindness.
ولطفك.
Your gentleness.
ولطفك.
Your love.
وحبك.
Towards our lives.
علينا.
And I thank you today.
وأشكرك اليوم.
That you've never offended us.
إنه ما أذيتنا بحياتنا.
You've never done things wrong against us.
إنه ما خليتنا ما سويت لنا.
You've never harmed us.
وما أذيتنا.
You've never done us damage.
وما حطمت حياتنا.
Because you're a just God.
لأنك الله عادل.
Lord, let this message remain in our hearts from today onwards.
صلي أن هذه تكون رسالة في قلوبنا.
For we ask it in Jesus' name.
يسوع المسيح.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor.
شكرا.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. ربي بارك الكلمة. أشكر رب من أجل هذا الرجل رجل الله. أحب أحكي شغلة واحدة بالنسبة ل أحب أشكر شكر خاص لإلهي. مارك ابني الكبير تركنا عمره 12 سنة من بغداد وبلش دخل مدارس باللغة الإنجليزية. وقف دراسته باللغة العربية. وإحنا كنا نصلي أنا وأمه أنه يا رب إحنا هذا الولد مفروض خادم إلك. لما طلبنا أنه يترجم قال أنا مو زين بالعربي. فأنت you made a good job. رب يباركك. شكرا جزيلا. فحقيقة كانت فتشي من الرب لأن الولد مدى يدرس عربي كل هالسنين من عمره 12 سنة وهسه 21 فنشكر رب أنه بعدها موجودة اللغة معاه حتى يساعد أبوه بالخدمة ويساعدكم ويخدمكم هو وأندرو.